Our job in jumping is to get the horse to the fence so that we can get him to jump the fence with a good takeoff and a good landing. Now, then we have to ask ourselves, well, what does that mean? What's a good takeoff? Well, how the horse judges the takeoff, providing he's in a rhythm and not really strong in the bit and just running flat back to the jump, providing he's in a good rhythm and reasonable self-carriage, then the optimal takeoff and landing spots, which are equidistant either side of the fence, the optimal takeoff distance and landing is about 1 to 1.5 times the height of the fence. So 1.5 times the height of the fence is something like that. That would mean that our optimal spot is around about here. For horses that are pure show jumpers, it's more like 1 times the height, it's a little bit closer. And for other horses and some event horses, it's a little bit further out. But nonetheless, this is the optimal spot. Now, that doesn't mean it's the only spot, because deeper than this is all doable, and this is the deep spot, this square here. And then similarly out here, we have the long spot, which is still doable. So this is really the zone where it's all possible. And as you can imagine, the higher the jump gets, then the more these zones are expanded. So that's optimal. Now, if we train the horse to be relaxed and he canters with a nice 12-foot or 3.6 metre long stride length, then you will find he will always get within this zone. And that's the importance of teaching the horse to have a rhythm in jumping, whereby the horse just canters at 110 beats, 105 to 110 beats per minute per leg, canter, 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 jump, takeoff. As I said, the landings will be the same distance on the other side. And so no matter where we come round from the corner, as we head towards that, providing he's doing 12-foot stride length, which we train him to do, he will be in this zone. So that's the takeoff and landing. If the fence is a different shape, for example, if it's a rising spread, for example, a triple bar that starts here and rises up, we measure from the highest rail. If it's a what we call a hog's back, where the middle of the fence is the highest point, tapering down to two rails either side, then it's still from the highest point. If we look at it in terms of a parallel oxer, where it's like a box and the two rails are of the same height, then what we do is we imagine a rail in the middle and 1/3 the height again. And so that would make it around about here, and that would be like jumping a single fence of that height. And that will slightly alter our optimal spot, as will all the other shapes. But nonetheless, we measure from that highest point, and again to 1 to 1.5 times the height. So that's our job. So really, it all boils back to the most important element is that the fence for the horse shouldn't be a trigger for rushing or slowing or swerving. We get the horse there nicely in a rhythm, that's our job. But once he takes off, that is his job. How he handles himself in the air is up to him, and we can train that by doing, for example, grid work.